And space fans from all over the world came out to the Space Coast this morning for the historic launch. And West 2's Spencer Tracy continues our team coverage from Titusville.
Amazing.
A major milestone soars over the Space Coast. People got a front row seat at Spaceview Park in Titusville.
It was a perfect day for it. A little bit of haze, but yeah, the rumble and, you know, all that excitement at the launch was absolutely amazing.
People came from all over the world to watch the launch of Polaris Dawn, as far as Venezuela, Switzerland, Canada, and of course people from the states, including Minnesota, and of course some locals here in Florida. This mission is reaching heights higher than any human has traveled in decades.
There were tears shed for Inspiration 4, and this one equally trumped it, and I think they're going to do awesome things moving forward.
The Vaultbrick family continues to follow Jarek Isaacman and his crew each mission into space.
It is a family affair. One of my friends went in on Inspiration 4 with Jared, and we got the kids interested and decided to wake everybody up super late early.
From waking up early to traveling to the Space Coast, this is something people couldn't miss.
And for me, this is a bit of a bucket list situation, so I'm never watched a launch before. I'm very excited.
To seeing the sky illuminate as the rocket takes off is something this crowd will never forget.
It's just incredible. Always space.
In Titusville, Spencer Tracy, West 2 News.
It looks so beautiful seeing the night or dark sky, I should say, lit up because it happened at 5:23 this morning. All right, here's a look at the timeline for this mission. Polaris Dawn will be on a 5-day journey, and later today, the crew will start preparing for their spacewalk with breathing exercises. The Dragon capsule is expected to pass through the inner regions on Earth's Van Allen radiation belt, setting the record for the highest orbit for a crewed mission. Tomorrow, they will do spacewalk preparations, more of those, and then they will also do a book reading for St. Jude patients and Anna's family. Thursday, day 3, that's the big spacewalk, which will be the first for an all-civilian crew. There will be a Starlink demonstration on Friday. And then on Saturday, the crew will get ready to come back to Earth before they splash down off the coast of Florida on Sunday. Lots to look forward to. And this is all to support research for how the human body reacts to different space conditions and further develop spacesuits and communication to help send astronauts back to the moon and maybe even Mars. We'll have to see. All right, we will bring you this historic spacewalk live when it happens. Again, that's scheduled for Thursday. And then this weekend, we will be watching as those astronauts return to Earth. You can learn more about the mission and watch these milestones on air and online at WESH.com.